Here we go. Effortless speed. Add a bit of distance to your game. 7 iron there. Total distance 185, and it's quite simple with these tips to be able to do it. So we all want more speed in your swing. You want to be able to hit the ball further and gain distance. And this is something that I often spend a lot of time with clients working on, how far they hit the ball, trying to gain those yards, trying to get the ball out there a little bit further. And there's a couple of simple things that you can do to really help that. And there's a couple of key things that most people get wrong that's killing their speed gains and making them lose distance. So, understanding a couple of key things. First one is what the left arm does through the swing. So in order to gain speed and distance, and then how your body needs to turn and rotate to be able to achieve that, extremely important. Okay, so what you've got to feel is that as you're coming in, that your left hand is turning that way. Okay, so supination. So you want to be able to get that left wrist to roll and get here on the way through. It's that's going to make you hit the ball faster. But it's also about swinging it smooth. So a simple drill to be able to get you to do that, very, very important. So a majority of people, this is what you're going to see. Certainly from a coaching point of view, this is what I see. So set yourself up, and I'll say to a client, okay, let's try to swing a little bit faster. Let's try and hit the ball a little bit harder. And the change in direction from the top of the backswing into the downswing is at that point that they add the speed in there. So as soon as you're starting to change direction, hitting it hard from the top, and that just, it actually slows you down, because if you want to feel like there's a gradual increase in speed as the downswing, not a massive increase at the top, because as you come down, you're going to slow down. So what you're often going to see is get to the top, hit it hard, and then effectively throw the club out there, and then lose all the power. And all that happens is, you know, for all of that effort to stand there, really change, and actually, as they come through, they're not using their hands anywhere near enough and slowing down, so it kind of looks like this. So sort of turn through, hold on to the club, and for all of the effort that you stand there and put in, you end up just not gaining the distance. So then what do you do? Okay, so what one simple drill that I like to get people to do to really get the feel of trying to add a little bit of speed to their swing, and trying to get away from, as a right-hand golfer, a right-hand dominant swing, trying to get away from that a little bit and get another feel into it, so it's really trying to get that supination of the left arm, is I would encourage you to stand there and let go of the club with your right hand. So as you swing down, feel like you let go around this point. So as you swing down, you want to feel like that right hand lets go of the club when your hands are more or less level with your right leg. And then as you swing through, it's at that point you can't hold on to the club and steer it that way. What'll happen is naturally that arm will turn, fold, release, the left arm will supinate. That's where the speed's gonna come in, and you can hear it. So as you stand there and swing, feel yourself let go. Just get that feeling of swinging it with a little bit more freedom and a little bit more relaxed in the hitting area of the ball, so that it's down there where you wanna put the speed in. Then set yourself up and actually make the swing. Normal backswing, so transition from backswing to downswing, smooth, then get the feeling that when you get to this point of your swing, it's there that you're gonna put the speed in. That should help you add a few yards to your game and get you hitting it a little bit further.